Hi everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video I'm going to show you every single way there is to copy and paste on Mac without installing any additional software. So here we are in a Google Doc, and I'm going to start out just by talking about the methods of copying and pasting, and then we'll talk about some more complex situations. So when we talk about copying and pasting, we first think about text, and we're going to talk about files and different things like that in the future. But for copying and pasting text, we obviously need to highlight the text that we'd like to copy, and maybe I'll highlight this whole paragraph. And then there are a few different things we can do from here. Kind of the old school original way is to go up to the edit menu. You'll notice that we can either cut or copy this text. If I copy it, it's going to copy it to my clipboard and it's going to leave it on the page. If I were to cut it, however, it would copy it to the clipboard but then remove it from the page. So that's nice if you're moving information and you don't want it where it originally was. If you want to leave it where it originally was, you just want to copy. Now, notice that from the edit menu, we also have this paste option, and then we also have paste and match style. So paste will paste it exactly as you copied it, and paste and match style will paste it with the formatting that this document currently has. So for example, if I were to copy something different, let's say I copy this heading right here, and I go up to edit and I copy it. If I just go up here and I paste it, you'll notice that it comes in with the heading and all that. I'm going to undo that. If I were to paste it in match style, you'll notice that it comes in with just the regular paragraph style. So that's what the difference between those two pasting options. Now, to get a little more advanced, instead of going up to the edit menu, we can actually highlight our text and we can right click. You'll notice that when we right click, we have the same options. So we can cut it, we can copy it, and then if we were pasting, we could paste it or paste without formatting. So you have the exact same options when you right click. And this goes for copying and pasting other things too, like files on your computer. You can go to the edit menu, you can right click, or you can use keyboard shortcuts. So let's talk about keyboard shortcuts. So the keyboard shortcut to copy on Mac is to press and hold the Command or Apple key and then press C to copy. If you wanted to cut, you could press and hold the Command or Apple key and press X, and you'll notice that it cuts it out. And then to paste text on Mac, we're going to hold the Command key and then press V to paste our text. If we wanted to paste it in match style, what we would do is we would do Command Shift V, and you'll notice that it matches the style of the heading there. So that's how we can do the keyboard shortcut for pasting and matching style. I also want to mention that if at any point you want to copy everything that's in a particular document, or even when we start talking about files, all the files in a folder, you can always select all. So with your cursor on the page, you can go up to edit, and in Google Docs, we actually have to do it from the Google Docs edit menu. It can be kind of confusing, but if we hit select all right here, you'll notice that everything on the page is selected. Alternatively, we can do Command A, and that works pretty much everywhere. So that's the one that I use. You'll notice that it selects everything on the page. So I could then hit Command C to copy it, and I could paste it somewhere. And again, this works the same for files and folders as well. I want to mention, if you use a Windows keyboard on Mac like I do, instead of using the Command key, because there isn't one, you're going to use the Windows key. So it's Windows C to copy, Windows X to cut, Windows V to paste. Just want to mention that since there are some Mac users that do use a Windows keyboard. Moving on. One question I get asked a lot is, how can we screenshot to clipboard? So instead of just copying the text, let's say I just wanted to take a picture of what's on my screen. Well, there's a keyboard shortcut for that, and it is Command, Shift, Control, and 4. You'll notice that when I press that keyboard shortcut, I get these crosshairs, and I could select the portion of the screen that I want to screenshot. When I do that, it's now been copied to my clipboard, so I could go over to, say, an email here, and then I could use the Command V command to paste that screenshot in, and you'll notice that there it is. Now, I also want to talk a little bit about pasting files and folders on Mac. So let's go to my desktop, and you'll notice that I have some files here on my desktop. So we can copy and paste these files the exact same way. So we can click on them and we can right click, and we can go down to copy, and then we can just right click and we can paste, and you'll notice that it now duplicated that file. But I want to mention that you can actually copy and paste multiple files as well. So I can either click and drag if I'm in a folder on my desktop, or alternatively I could click on a file, then hold the Command key, and then I can select all of the files that I would like to copy. Then I can press Command C and then Command V, and you'll notice that they're pasted. You can also copy and paste folders. So if I had a folder here and all of these items were inside of it, we'll just move them all in there. Instead of going into this folder and copying all of these items, I can just copy the entire folder. So I could go to the folder and then I could go to copy, and then I could just paste it here on the desktop. So now I have two copies of the same folder, so I have duplicates of all the documents inside. The final thing I want to mention is that if you want to view the clipboard on your Mac computer, you want to make sure that you're in the Finder application, so you might have to click down here on the Finder smiley face guy. And then you're going to go to Edit and Show Clipboard. And it just tells you what's on the clipboard. So if you have an image or something like that, it's not actually going to show a picture of it. It just shows the title of the document. And you can only have one item on your clipboard at once. If you want to get a clipboard where you can store multiple items on Mac, you do have to install a third-party application. Let me know if you'd like to see a video on that, and I can try and get that up for you. But these are all the ways that you can natively copy and paste on Mac. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.